it's a great institution. This college operates on three campuses. This one, of course, we call our main campus. We have an annex on West 2nd South. And we have a downtown campus, which is the old trail line we're building on 4th South and 6th East. The fall quarter is usually the largest quarter here at the college. Last fall, we had 6,500 students distributed on these three campuses in day and evening programs. We provide training here at the college in 23 different occupational areas. The Health Occupations Division is one of the largest on campus. We graduate two classes of practical nursing each year, one in March and the other in September. And in June this year, we'll graduate approximately 700 individuals who are training in other divisions here at the college. Utah Technical College is truly a college of higher education. And that higher is spelled H-I-R-E. Because we have a phenomenal placement record. Practically every individual who attends this institution is placed on a job. And I would venture to say all of these graduates graduating tonight either have jobs or have had opportunities to take jobs if they want them. We have six buildings on this campus. We have another one presently under construction. There are several other buildings that are being planned and are in the planning stages at this time. During the past 28 years that Utah Technical College has been in existence, these nursing programs have operated, we have graduated 1,530 practical nurses. Now that includes the 45 who will receive their graduation certificates tonight. Now, of course, I contend that that's a sizable contribution to the welfare of this community. Hospital facilities here in the Valley are the chief stumbling block to our training additional nursing students. We're using virtually every hospital in the Valley as on-the-job training laboratories for our health occupations courses. We're very grateful for the cooperation of the hospitals. In fact, the health occupations programs, particularly the LPN program, would not operate without the cooperation of the hospitals. Speaking of cooperation, it reminds me of the high school boy who bought a new pair of pants to attend the junior prom. And he went to the store just the night before the big dance, and as he said to the haberdasher, "I'd like those pants." The haberdasher said, "Well, fine, but I'm sorry, we won't really have time to sharpen them an inch for you before the big dance tomorrow night." And the young man said, "Oh, that's okay, I'll take them home to Mother. I know she'll sharpen them." The mother was tremendously involved, and she wasn't able to do it, so she apologetically said, "Dave, I'm just sorry that I won't have time this evening. Why don't you ask your sis?" So he went to his sis and said, "Will you sharpen my pants an inch?" And she said, "Very sorry, but gee, I'm learning my part for the school play. Why don't you ask Grandma? It's my bridge night. I just don't have time," said Granny. So the young man registered his disappointment, went off to bed, figuring perhaps that he would have time the next morning to take the pants over to the tailor's and get them sharpened an inch. When he took the pants out of the closet the next morning, he found that something was drastically wrong. It was immediately apparent that the pants were much too sharp. Now, in questioning members of the family, this is what he found out. "I felt sorry for you, Dave, and I sharpened your pants an inch when I came home," said Mom. "And I didn't know she did it, so I sharpened them an inch too," said Sis. "And the same thing applies to me," blushed Grandma. Well, the moral of that little story is that cooperation without coordination will certainly result in a disaster. I'm very happy to report to you that there is excellent cooperation and coordination between the hospitals and Utah Technical College. This class that's graduating tonight started out a year ago with 80 students enrolled. Tonight we're graduating 45. You can see that the mortality rate is very high. So that certainly means to me that those who have succeeded are real solids, and we're proud of them. Now, when the LPN LPN class started 28 years ago, you know, the college only had a director of nursing and one practical nursing instructor. Today, our health occupations department is comprised of a division chairman and 14 instructors of health occupations. The health occupations faculty of this college is a great faculty, and they do a great job. Many years ago, I became acquainted with the teacher's dream. I'd like to share it with you this evening. This creed said, the mediocre teacher talks. The good teacher explains. The superior teacher demonstrates. The great teacher inspires. Now, I can assure all of you here tonight, faculty here at the Health Occupations Division of Utah Technical College would rate high on any measuring scale. We have the opportunity to meet with them this evening, and I'm confident the students share my opinion. They are a great faculty. Now, since the graduates are accustomed to hearing the doctors give orders during their hospital training, I thought perhaps they might appreciate this. It seems that the doctor, who was sleeping soundly one night and he was wakened by his wife, she said, honey, the bulb is making so much noise, I just can't sleep. Will you please call the plumber? Well, the doctor said, here. You see, it's only 4 o'clock in the morning, which his wife was calling. I know what time it is. I can read. Well, your patients want you in the middle of the night. Hesitate to call him. So he thought for a few seconds and said, okay, dear, what do you do? You go in, drop 3 aspirin tablets down the bowl, flush it, call me at 7 o'clock in the morning. In our graduating class tonight, I thought it was interesting as the person faculty gave me a few statistics about the group. I wasn't able to tell which 5 it is because they all look radiant tonight. But there are 5 of them who have recently become engaged and married, so you'll probably be able to tell by the blush on their face that you can see down in that corner of the room. I also was very interested to learn that the 21 out of the 25 graduates tonight have attended other post-high school institutions prior to the time they came to Utah Technical. There are 4 out-of-state students here, there's 2 return missionaries here, and the children this evening who are attending in the audience, I'm sure, represent their families. We know that there's at least 44 children here tonight, and of course, delighted to have them here. Now, if I may, just one last thought. One of the primary responsibilities of an education institution is to prepare students for a successful and happy life. One of the essential requisites for a successful and happy life is a proper attitude. It's been over 2 years ago since I heard a gentleman by the name of Bob Richards speak on the subject of motivation. Many of you have heard Bob Richards on television and radio. He is a renowned speaker, an Olympic champion, won 5 gold medals. He's a former minister, he's a very successful businessman. Talk this night was, the most important thing in life is your mental attitude. The most important thing in life is your mental attitude. It's the power within, he said, that determines how successful we'll be in life. And then he admonished all of us at the meeting that evening to push the belief up. Believe that you can do it, certainly you will achieve. Positive thinking will certainly make your objective in our junior class. Positive thinking can certainly make graduation become a reality in September. I certainly add my endorsement to the admonition of Bob Richards, and I would say to all of us, think positively about our family.
communications with our teachers. I know some of the outstanding laughter and experiences that I had was when we were in the shot lab and was learning how to give each other shots. First of all, we practiced out in Oregon, shooting in vitamin C or sugar water. And then when we gained enough confidence to go and do it to each other, we grabbed a partner and went in to get passed out. Well, I remember my partner was very confident, and she took my arm and she took the alcohol swab, cleaned it very well. She grabbed it thoroughly. She inserted the needle, missing the spot completely, taking it out and hitting me again. I was a little upset at the moment, but then afterwards I realized this was really quite a funny experience, so I had a laugh about it. We also had some other fun experiences, just learning the basic fundamentals of nursing, how to give bed baths to one another, and sitting on a cold bedpan. I know that I will never get my patient one of those. We experienced many funny things, and these things pulled us and brought us together. Then there were the times of success and achievement. And it's just such a wonderful feeling of satisfaction to know that each and every one of us have fulfilled the requirements expected of us to graduate here. Times it was very difficult, and it was a hard course we had to study about this. I'm very thankful for this opportunity to be able to accomplish this. And right now, I'm experiencing a ton of thankfulness. but I'm